Good evening. In this lecture, we are going to study about how to print the pattern of star using the nested for loop. Suppose this is the question given to you in the exam, like write a program to print the following pattern of star, and this pattern is given to you. If you see this pattern carefully, there are 5 stars on the first row. On the second row, there are 4 stars. On the third row, there are 3 stars. Fourth row, there are 2 stars. On fifth row, there is only 1 star. It means the logic that we get from this image or pattern is every row, when you increase the number of row, the number of stars are decreasing in every row. Correct. So, we need only 2 variables into the program, that is I and j. We take I for rows and j for columns. So, we will start with the header files, hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h. void main will start the program. This opening bracket will indicate the start of the program. Here we declare the variables required into this program, that is I and j. I is for rows and j is for columns. This clear screen line will going to clear the screen. Then we will write the outer for loop in such a way that it will going to decrease the value of I every time when it goes from one row to another row. Here we write for I equals to 5, semicolon I greater than equals to 1, semicolon I minus minus. It means that it is a backward loop which starts with the higher number and goes till a lower value. So, this loop indicates that it is going to be executed 5 times. Outer for loop. Okay. So, inside the outer for loop, we will write another loop which actually print the stars on that particular row. So, we will write a inner for loop in such a way that it is going to print the appropriate stars on that particular row. For j equal to 1, j less than equal to I, j plus plus, printf here will print 1 star in this inner for loop. Once it is completed, to go to the next row, we will use a printf line like this, which shift the cursor to the next row. And here we close the outer for loop. Getch will stop the output somewhere on the screen. And this closing bracket is the closing of this program. Now we will see the handrun of this program and we will check how the pattern gets printed. We will start with this for loop. Here, if you see, I value is initialized to 1 and the condition is also true. It means it allows us to enter into the inner for loop. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 5, because the I value that is coming from outer for loop is 5 here, j plus plus. It means that this loop will start with 1, it goes till I value, j value 5. It executes this printf statement 5 times. It means on the first row it prints 5 stars like this. After printing the 5th star, j value becomes 6. When j value becomes 6, this condition becomes false and it stops the execution of the inner for loop. When it exits from the inner for loop, it goes to the next line, that is printf slash n. It means it shifts the cursor to the next row. It means we are on the second row now. Here, okay. From here, it goes to decrement the value of I in outer for loop because we have written I minus minus in the third part of the outer for loop. So now I value becomes 4. Previously it was 5. Now it becomes 4, and from here it goes back to check the condition here. Again, the condition is true, and the inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 4, j plus plus. It means that this for loop will going to print 4 stars on the second row, like this. After printing the 4th star, j becomes 5 and this condition becomes false here. When this condition becomes false, it exits from the inner for loop and this line shifts the cursor to the third row. When you go to the third row, I value becomes 3. From here, again check the outer condition. Outer condition is true. inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 3, j plus plus. It means that this for loop is going to print 3 stars on the third row. After exiting from this inner for loop, this printf statement shifts the cursor to the fourth row, where I value becomes 2. And the condition is true. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 2, j plus plus. It means on the fourth row, it prints 2 stars. After printing 2 stars, it exits from the inner for loop. And this slash n line, printf line, shift the cursor to the fifth row, where I value is now 1. When I value is 1, condition is again true. It allows us to enter in the inner for loop. And this loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 1, j plus plus. It means this loop will going to execute the code at least once. So it prints 1 star on the 5th row. After completing that, it shifts the cursor to the 6th row. From here, it goes back to decrement the value of I. Now I value becomes 0. And this condition, outer condition, becomes false. When this condition becomes false, it stops the execution of the nested for loop. At the end, you will find a pattern of star like this on the screen. So this ends the printing of this pattern of stars. If you have any doubt, please write your questions into the chat room. Any doubts? Thank you.